Hey, what's up, everybody? It is me, King Alpha. Hope everybody's doing great. So today I want to talk to you guys about everything about World War III, in terms of, you know, getting access, what happens if you already own the game, what's going to be in the game, all the type of news that you need to know. For anybody wondering, yes, I have not really been doing Conqueror's Blade. I've been trying to strive a little bit more towards World War III, Battlefield 2042, and then a little bit of Age of Empires 4 when it comes out at the end of this month. So I am sorry there has not been Conqueror's Blade content. Honestly, Conqueror's Blade for me has been a bit dry and has been dying out. So I'll probably make another video coming up soon, but, you know, just stay tuned for that. Anyways, World War III, everything we need to know, and basically, you know, in terms of access, all that type of stuff. So first off, I'm going to say they are going to have 5 maps so far. It seems like the classic maps, Warsaw, Berlin, Moscow, Polnary, and... I can't say the word. Anyways, basically 5 maps at launch so far in terms of the closed beta. Now you're wondering, okay, I knew they had an alpha test. How do I get into the closed beta? I want to get into the closed beta. So you can buy these closed beta packs. Now these closed beta packs, you have the private pack, sergeant pack, lieutenant pack, and then the major pack, right? You have the private pack, which gives you the CBT access, which basically is the closed beta on November 25th. But you don't get the battle pass. You get an identification, which is basically a avatar or a banner, basically. And then you also get a weapon emblem. But you don't get the operator blueprints, the weapon blueprints, strike blueprints. And you don't get 15,000 UNC, which is the in-game currency. Then you have the sergeant pack, which is, you still get the same stuff. You really don't get the battle pass either. However, you do get the operator and weapon blueprints that the private pack does not have. So that's obviously a bonus for $15 extra as well. Mind you, I believe in the beginning, this game did cost like, what, $25, I think, to go in order to get into the early access. So this is actually not too bad. You do get things. And if you do want to actually see what the blueprints are and everything, I'll show them in a bit. Then you have the lieutenant pack. So this lieutenant pack is $50. It gets you all the access to the closed beta and everything. You get the battle pass, all the other stuff, and you get strike blueprints as well. But you do not get the 15,000 UNC. And then you have the $250 pack, which obviously gets you just the extra UNC, which is the in-game currency. That is all depending on whether you obviously, you know, want to buy this and play in the closed beta. However, this game is actually going to be free to play when it comes out in March, which basically actually in March is going to be the open beta in March. That's what they said. But I don't know if that's considered, you know, open beta fully release yet. So we'll have to see. And hopefully they said that they're going to be putting in content during the closed beta so that, you know, players can keep playing and they're going to keep making sure they work out all the kinks. Now, for any players that actually already own the game, you're going to be getting the veteran pack. Now, this veteran pack is really, really good. And for players that did buy this game when, you know, it was in early access, we basically got a lot of stuff. So we got the CBT access, so you already get the closed beta access, which is really nice. You get the season 1 battle pass, and you get the lieutenant pack. So everything in the lieutenant pack, the blueprints, all that type of stuff, you actually do get as well. And then future content incoming. Not everything will be available at launch, but it's coming. Take a look at all the amazing content that will be coming your way in the World War III OBT. So you have the veteran blueprint. So this is how I'm assuming it's basically going to be the outfit in terms of the glasses and all that type of stuff, which is pretty cool. You have the UKM veteran. So it's basically going to have like a nice skin on it. I'm assuming this is also going to be a blueprint because there is blueprints in World War III. You have the Wolverine vehicle blueprint. You have character blueprints in terms of US and Russian riflemen. Then you also have the MG Groundbreak, which is the LMG, which is yet another blueprint, like I said, which also does confirm that the MG5 is actually going to be in this game as well. So the MG5 was not in the alpha test, so it's really good to see that at least some guns are actually going to be in the game. Then you have the Ronin helmet, which is the resistance. If you guys didn't see this helmet was also, you know, you're a veteran, so you should know it was in the previous game, so you could wear it. And you have the Martyr Knight Operations IFV. So this is pretty cool stuff. Probably not all the stuff the veterans are going to be getting. And yeah, that's basically it in terms of the veteran pack. Now, let me talk about the president pack, which was just like a little quick thing. It was literally only available to one person. I'm assuming it's been bought. But basically, you get a lifetime of all battle passes for forever. You get the CBT access. You get to feature in a movie, a lead role in a World War III movie. And then you also get a real-life replica of the Ronin helmet, which is crazy. You also get a unique player avatar, and you get weapon and you get a weapon and a strike, unique, like, well, it says an exclusive weapon and strike based on your preferences. You also get 1,500,000 UNC, which I think is the accumulative of, like, I don't know how much money, but it's a lot. They also create a map based off your home location. You get a unique gold weapon, a unique copper weapon, 3 armor blueprints, Ronin helmet, and the MG5 groundbreak. So, yeah, I mean, the coolest thing, I think, personally, out of everything is the fact that they will make a map on your home location. Really hope that they actually do this. I hope they fully follow through with this, whoever did buy this, because it is definitely worth it, and I'm really, really excited for that. So now let's go back into the packs real quick. I want to show you guys basically some of the blueprints and everything that they were basically talking about. So let me see if I can actually, I actually had it, but I don't know where it was. It was like literally there for me 2 seconds ago. Anyways, the blueprints in the thing, it just basically looks like any of the other blueprints. But make sure you do subscribe, though. If you subscribe, you're actually able to get a little blueprint bonus as well, which is a handgun blueprint, which actually looks pretty sick. You get the little flashlight, you got extended mags, I'm assuming, a nice little color, a little white color on the pistol, and then you have some sights as well. So make sure you do subscribe as well. So you want to make sure you're getting all in for this. But, guys, November 25th is the day for World War III, and I know November 25th, that is literally 13 days after, you know, if you bought the gold or ultimate edition of Battlefield 2042, you know, yes, yeah, 13 days after Battlefield 2042, but this closed beta actually doesn't end until March of next year. So it's going to be amazing. You're going to be able to play it nonstop. And I think it's going to be a hell of a grind to actually play both Battlefield 2042 and World War III at the same time. I hope you guys enjoy. If you guys have any questions or anything, let me know. And definitely comment down below. I would like to see some. So peace.